Hello and welcome everyone on the online community watching us on Facebook, YouTube or wherever this may be. I'm Nigel Cameron and this is my wife Julie Cameron Hall, and over here on keyboards we have Chris Smith, and we'd like to play for you some from our Celtish albums. To start with, we would like to introduce a version of a psalm that we were drawn to last year when we first went into lockdown. Many of the psalms talk about our response to fear, and many of us had the fear of the unknown as we were locked in our houses in fear of this deadly virus. This is a really powerful psalm which speaks into that, and this is our version of "The Lord is My Light," Psalm 27.
Thank you. Thank you. abiding, no change my heart shall feel. And safe is such confiding, for nothing changes he. The storm may roar around me, my heart may though be laid, my Father's arms surround me. How can I be then you remind me of your promises. I need not fear, just be still. I need not fear, just be still.
Called Do Not Worry, and it was a tune that our friend Phil Hart, who was playing guitar on that track, composed that melody, didn't he, Nigel?
Yes, and the title that he gave for the melody, it was part of a longer piece, which that was the start section of. The title he gave it was Three Boys, and the music that he played and created literally was a prayer for his boys. Now, we have written some lyrics to quite a few of Phil's beautiful melodies before, and when it came to maybe put some lyrics to this particular one, I thought, well, I can't really write a song for Phil's three boys. I mean, I do know them, but it's the prayer of his father's heart. So we actually were staying in Brussels at the time with my daughter-in-law and her family, and I sort of thought, do you know what? Well, maybe I need to think about what would I write for my daughter. I have a daughter who lives in the USA, and we've got a two-year-old grandson, and what would I write for them? And I realized that over many years, I have had fears, I have had worries about their well-being, and so I started to write the lyric that you've just heard. Sometimes I feel afraid for my family, sometimes I worry about my children. And literally, as I wrote those words down on a page, I heard a scream from a couple of floors upstairs.
And the scream was me. And I could not find our three-year-old grandson anywhere in the house. 2 minutes before, he'd been happily playing at my feet. And I searched up and down into the attics. I could not find him anywhere. And I was terrified that he had fallen out of the window. And Nigel had literally just written the words, yes. Do not worry. Sometimes I feel afraid for my family.
And where did I end up finding him? Climbing up one set of stairs, and we realised there was a door ajar, and there was a little lump underneath bedclothes in a spare bedroom, and there he was, hiding quiet as a mouse.
The little monkey was hiding from his granny.
But we were tested on those lyrics I had just written, and sometimes that happens and we feel afraid, but we know that you know, we have a faithful God.
Yeah, and that God cares even more for our children than we do. And this next song is also about his care for little children. And it was inspired by a dream I had about children in heaven. It's called Darkest Day.
Shed over daughters and sons.
Well, one of the things we love to do is to find some gorgeous Celtic melodies, some of which have been around for maybe hundreds of years, and maybe find words to go with them. Now, last year, 2020, when we came out of the first lockdown, we went to Ireland and we stayed in a beautiful place that I remembered being in through doing family camps there. And it's a place called the Meeting of the Waters. I mean, just the title is you know, evokes a beautiful place because two rivers come together there. And it's in County Wicklow, which is otherwise known as the Garden of Ireland, in a valley called the Vale of Avoca. Now, while we were staying there, a friend of mine said, Nigel, have you heard the song called The Meeting of the Waters? Now, I knew there was a song that existed, but I never knew what the melody was. And when I Googled it and heard the melody, I'd actually heard it before because we'd sung a hymn to it. And on our album, we put this to the hymn, My Jesus, I Love Thee. But today, Julie's going to sing the original folk song because it's just beautiful.
And I really wanted to sing the original folk song to this tune, not least because Thomas More wrote these words to this tune. But because this gathering that we're having is online, and I know we're longing to be together and that screens aren't quite good enough anymore, this song is all about how beautiful the countryside is, but it's not as beautiful as being together with friends, and that's what makes life particularly beautiful. It's called The Meeting of the Waters.
There is not in the whole world a valley so sweet as that vale in whose bosom the bright waters meet. Looks that we love.
This next song is called The Great Reunion. And this is another one of these songs that started out as an acoustic guitar instrumental. When I first heard it, I was really moved by it, and I thought, goodness me. And my friend Phil, who wrote the music, really was thinking of friends that he had lost and who are now in heaven. And I thought, wouldn't it be great to add lyrics to this tune? And it took me to some scriptures about, you know, those who mourn will be comforted. And so we'd like to dedicate this song now to all of those whose families have lost loved ones. Yes, during COVID, but really anybody who, you know, there's an empty chair. And we know that as Christians, we have this hope of being reunited one day with our loved ones in heaven. This is The Great Reunion.
Thank you.
Okay, well, thank you all so much for listening to our Celtish concert. You'll find all of our music and albums very easily by going to Celtish.org. And tonight we've featured one or two instrumentals from our first Celtish album, then our Celtish Devotion album, 2019's, and our brand new album for 2021, Celtish Home. And, you know, I know we're all watching from home, and many of the songs are about our heavenly home. This final one was written, well, it was a poem written by a friend of ours we met on the island of Lindisfarne.
Which you probably all know.
Andy Rain. Well, actually, I first found the prayer. It's actually a prayer attributed to St. Aidan, and you can buy mugs with it on and everything. And I found this prayer and thought about maybe using it. And only when we started to record it, we discovered it was actually written
by Andy.
The poem was written by Andy Rain. We just jiggled it around a bit and got his wonderful permission to record
Inspired
this prayer.
By the teaching.
In fact, my friend Phil Hart, who plays guitar on some of the music we've been playing, he uses this particular song, he told me, for his quiet time every morning. And there's something about that, just retreating to an island. And we've been in Lindisfarne and know how it's very tidal. And when the tide comes in, it's cut off from the mainland. And there's just something in that, you know, reflective of this past year that we've all been having. Sometimes we've been locked at home, and you know what? It's just God and us. All the world around us, you know, is important, but sometimes we need to focus on just our relationship with Him. But many times when that happens, when we retreat into Him, He then inspires us to go out and take this Father's love that we've found to the world. So this is our interpretation, and a beautiful melody actually written by Julie to these words from the poem by Andy Rain. So God bless you. This is
thanks for listening.
Prayer of Aidan.
Thanks for listening.
Bless you.